Yeah, go for it. Get crazy, do some butts and stuff. What are you doing? Is that cold?
Here we go.
Yeah. Your water is building. Oh my god.
It's super cold.
Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. It's Artcast 413, and today I got two viewer questions. First one is about my studio. So I'm going to give you guys a studio tour and just kind of show you how I got my whole place set up. And the second one is about my art table. And my art table is a homemade deal, made it myself. I'm pretty proud of it, and I'll show you that. So come on, let's get going. Okay, so this is it. This is my full studio. This is a shot kind of from the door. As you can see, I got my animation set there, got my computer there. Let me step inside. Over there's my drawing table, and I got some shelves and stuff. And a bookcase over here. And the whole space is pretty small. It's only 8 by 8 feet, I believe, with of course some extra stuff taking up room. The door is a sliding door, just to give me a little bit more room. Because this place was just so tight when I first moved in here. Okay, all the walls, and including the ceiling up here, are all painted black. I do that because of the animation. I don't want the wall color affecting my lighting when I'm shooting, so I just thought the easiest thing to do was just paint the whole place black. There's my set, my animation set, all set up in here. I used to have this out in the shed, and I got so tired of fighting with the cold weather and the winter and all that kind of stuff that I just brought the whole thing in and shoved it right here in the corner. And it's actually functioning, you know, the lighting's up on it. Everything's working. I have everything wired back here to this back panel. All the lighting in here is all just can lights, the cheap can lights you get at Home Depot. And I use LED bulbs, which gives it a nice white light, not only for my set and stuff, but just for drawing. Okay, so here's kind of my overall workspace. There's my table and my camera and stuff. That's just kind of where my camera lives. It's always sitting there on a tripod ready to film some stuff if I need to for a video. My chair is just a office chair with the back taken off it. And I noticed that actually kind of helps me work. Like, you know, without the back on your chair, you don't really lean back and just, you know, screw around watching movies forever. My computer and stuff is over here. Let me put this on a tripod and show you. Okay, so here's my computer, and I'm going to show you guys this. See, it's on this desk type thing that you can slide around. And my router's down there, and my backup hard drives, of course my tower, and you know my main computer and keyboard and all that. And my headphones are hanging down here. And I did this so that I can, you know, if I need to go animate over here, and I need my computer close, I can slide it over there. So then if I need it like over here close to me, like while I'm drawing, you know, I can just slide it over here. And the cords are kind of just taped together and run over to the wall. I kind of set it up like this because I wanted a desktop setup. I didn't really want a laptop setup. The desktops I was looking at had, you know, more space and more storage and all that kind of stuff, and they were a little bit lower priced. I didn't want to struggle with editing the animation again, so I wanted something, you know, that could handle it, and it turned out to be a desktop. And then, you know, it's kind of like, what are you going to do, build your set like right next to your computer like every single time? So this became my solution. So anyway, this is the top of my desk, you know, where I work and draw and paint, and here's a piece I'm working on right now. This is kind of reference for my comic book here. These are actually a lot of the pages I haven't sold, and then the ones that I have sold, I just copy and put back inside this book. That's just so I remember how to draw the characters. And the front of this thing is all the storyboards I've been doing. for my next animation, and they're slowly growing and growing, and eventually will be something. So up here, I put a shelf up, and all of my color pencils live there. I just have a ton of them. You know, when you draw with a color pencil, you always need like a color. And they just are in, you know, little old soup cans and pickle jars and all that kind of stuff, and coffee mugs. And I try to keep them separated by color, but you know, they get mixed up from time to time. So now over here is kind of just my extra workspace. You know, it's like I build my puppets here, and I do, you know, anything that I don't need a flat surface for on this side. I didn't clean it up because, you know, you always see like the artists like studio type tours where they show their studio and it's like spotless and everything is 100% organized. And I always think, God, that's so fake, you know. You know, I'd imagine like if you want a tour of my studio, you want to see like it in its working state. You don't want to see this kind of like fakey cleaned up version. You just want to see the real thing. So anyway, this is the real thing. This is like what I was working with last night. I was working with color pencils and all that stuff and Sharpies. And they're all just still out, you know, because I don't really pick them up constantly. This right here is my water cup. Hopefully you guys can see this. And it actually sits in a little box that I screwed down. I don't know if, you know, you guys remember when I first started shooting video, like a long time ago when I started the Artcast, I was constantly taking my airbrush and wrapping into my thing and then knocking it over and spilling my water everywhere. So I ended up just making this little box out of 1x2s that my water sits in, and now I just can't get knocked over. This is my pallet, and it's just a little plastic lid that I have taped down. And what I like about that is, you know, it's like when the paint starts getting piled up on there, then I can just, you know, pull the lid off and bend it around and just kind of peel the paint off, and it works well. I only use acrylics in there and like watercolor type stuff. I never put oil in this. If I use oil, I always put a piece of tin foil down and I paint out of that tin foil. This is actually my airbrush and where it sits. This is just a screw sticking out of my table. You can just hook it on there. And then I usually have the cup that just goes right there. Actually, I usually do it that way so the cup doesn't fall off. And that's just a good position for it to kind of dry. You know, I rinse it out, stick it upside down, and then, you know, any kind of paint that's still in there kind of works its way that way instead of like down into there to clog it up. And then, you know, when I'm ready to airbrush, there we go. Okay, as long as we're down here, there is my compressor right there. It's what is it? Model 180 Badger oilless. And it just kind of lives right there. Over here, and I got it on another kind of sled type thing like I got my computer on. It's actually my scanner and my printer right here, as you guys can see. And you can just, you know, pull this out and print stuff as I need to. And then, you know, when I don't want it in the way anymore, just put it back in there. Works pretty well. All right, so way up high here, I kind of have my different shelves. I kind of keep my camera stuff like in there, like my cords and stuff. This is just my sort of my to-do list. It's like, you know, packages that I need to ship today, things like that. It's got art that I need to package, and you know, like that, I need to throw in my folder, like more packages, and it's just a shelf that's always got stuff on it for me to do. This is just some animation stuff, like bags of Sculpey for molding. There's some hand molds, just old, you know, stuff to put paint thinner in or paint out of. So up here is all my like silicone, like I got some foam latex over there, you know, mold release, varnish, paint thinners back in there, you know, spray mount, all that kind of stuff, some epoxy. This is sort of like where I stash all my poisonous stuff. I've always had this in every studio I've ever had. And that's like where I just put all the stuff that's gonna, you know, poison some little kid that, you know, gets into my studio. You know, every artist should kind of have a shelf like that where they kind of keep that stuff, you know, away from, you know, just people or little kids that just don't realize what it is. So this box has just got my lighting and stuff in it. So So right up here is where I kind of keep the puppets. That's where they live when they're not acting in, you know, my little movie. There's one that's kind of getting built. And yeah. And then down here I kind of got tape and wire and just stuff for making puppets over there. Some of my cords hanging there. Just a handy place to keep that stuff. That thing right there is actually just a big painting I did back, you know, a long time ago. That's I've dragged around from house to house. And I just screwed it up there as part of my studio. I just needed something to kind of block that wall off, block off that space behind that bookcase. So I just kind of screwed it up there, and I like it. It's kind of a cool painting. There's some of the detail. This is like when I used to, you know, want to paint big oils and be like Frank Frazetta. Over here, this is all animation stuff. Like, that's a bunch of LEDs. This is ball and socket stuff for my armature. Let me show you in some of this. See, and I got them all labeled for the next time I'm working on an armature. And you can see just a ton of the little brass balls that you need to make armatures with. So there's a finished joint right there. Cap screws, that kind of stuff. Wing nuts for tie downs. And they just all have the same kind of thing. I believe that one is faces. Hey, there's some of the replacement faces for the elf character. There's some latex hands and the glove. There's some faces for the guard character right there. And as you can see, I kind of try to keep them labeled somewhat, you know, like taps and bits. That's like drill bits and taps specifically for making armatures. That's just some drywall blades for my knife, for this knife right here. And yeah, there's my old camera. Let me show you guys my table now. Clear some stuff off of it. So the top of my table is just a normal drawing table that you get at any art store, like the big drawing table with the white tops. That's what this base is made of. This is just a piece of trim that I screwed on. See, like this thing right here is actually just a piece of trim that I screwed on with like some screws. There's like a screw right here, and then there's one down there and one right there in the center. That just keeps stuff from like sliding off. Like this part of the table right here is actually a piece of frosted glass that I got off of a place that I worked. I used to work for the paper in Boulder, the Daily Camera. And I worked there when they used to do everything analog and there wasn't any digital. And they had just all of these big giant tables that had this frosted glass for like a light board. And so that's actually what this is. I don't use it as a light board, obviously. My son's drawing on it and I have tape stuck to it, but that's what this piece of glass is right here. And my table actually does have a hole cut right here so that light could shine up through it and it could be a light board. I kind of converted it to that when I was doing a little bit of 2D animation and I needed a light board to see through my pictures as I drew. So now this whole thing actually folds up and you can see what I'm talking about. Whole thing lifts up. It all sits back here on a bunch of boards. So how am I gonna film that? So this is my table right here. The top's lifted up and I have these boards right here holding this up. So it looks like it's like a 2x2, a 2x4, and maybe a 2x6. Let me show you. See how that goes all the way back in there? And then my table actually sits down on it. And then you can kind of see, if you look back there, like there's the hole cut in the top that would let light come through if it needs to be a light table. But I don't have that set up right now. And then this table right here, the whole thing it's screwed onto is just a kitchen table. It's an old kitchen table, you know, one of those ones with the Formica top, I think they were called. And it's cut in half, and it's actually screwed straight into my wall. So that's the gist of it. That's my table and everything. My table has, you know, developed through like years of me kind of switching things around and changing things. And I've worked in construction a lot. So like, you know, building stuff and, you know, that's not a big deal for me, but it's really, you know, not that difficult. You know, if you got a circular saw and a drill and, you know, like one of those screw heads so that you can push a screw through something, you can do the same thing, you know, and the wood that it's made out of is just old scrap wood. This table is, I don't even know where I got that table. It's been so long. And, you know, the top you could literally pick up at Home Depot. It doesn't even have to be the top off one of those tables. Just go get yourself like, it's probably like an inch and a half thick MDF and you're good to go. So, you know, I encourage anybody who wants to try to make something like this, go for it, you know. And if I could help you in any way, if you need some advice, like email me and I'll try to guide you through it, you know. What else? The mailing list. Sign up for the mailing list if you guys want to keep up with, you know, what I'm doing, because that's a good way. I've got the mailing list there because I'm trying to guard against what YouTube does. You know, I don't have a clue what they're going to do next. You know, it's like with the demonetization and all that kind of stuff, I'm trying to sort of guard myself against like a Facebook situation where suddenly they're not putting my stuff out to like my subscribers. And that could totally happen. It happened with Facebook. It could totally happen with YouTube. The last thing I want to say is my patrons, I want to thank my patrons for like sticking with me through thick and thin, sticking with me when I'm not making videos, and you know, just helping out support the channel. You guys rock, and that's why you guys got, you know, have your name at the end of each video, because you know, you guys help me. You guys are the ones who really help me put this stuff out. So thanks guys, and I'll see you next time.